Hi everybody, welcome to Máiréad Mondays on YouTube and Facebook Live, and it's so great to see you all here. Thank you so very, very much for tuning in, and I am so excited to have my very special guest, Órla, original member of Celtic Woman and solo artist, and her new album Lore is out on July 24th, so that's very exciting. And thank you so much, everybody, for being with me today. And also midweek, don't forget about Máiréad Mondays, chats, tunes and crack podcast on all platforms. And the link is below also. And don't forget to share this stream now with your friends and have a watch party. Why not? I'm going to have a watch party later on with my Become a Supporter family on Facebook as well. And it's a great way to catch up with your friends and watch something together and share it with your friends. So I always love to do a collaboration video at the beginning of the show to just highlight the collaborations I've done with the most amazing artists, even during this COVID phase and beforehand as well. And I had the privilege to work with the brilliant Tim Janice and on Celtic Heart, on the PBS special Celtic Heart. And it was just the most amazing experience. And here in this clip, because we have the great Órla Fallon on today, and she's such an amazing harpist and harper, we have special guests as well in this little clip, the Camille and Kennerly Harp Twins, and Lynn Hillary, and Emer McGeown, and Tim Janice, and Ella, and myself in this tune. It's a beautiful, beautiful tune called The Kid on the Mountain. And I think you'll enjoy this. I think some of you may have seen it already, but it is just a really nice tune. And we did it in Celtic Heart. And also the arrangement was done by Tim Janice, and it's shot in different locations. So enjoy this. I hope you enjoyed that performance from Celtic Heart and with the amazing artists that I had a chance to collaborate on, and the brilliant Tim Janice. And go to his YouTube channels and his platforms and see all his wonderful music, you know, there on Spotify and all the platforms. And The latest from Carl Nesbitt. Here we go. Carl Nesbitt, a multi-instrumentalist, composer and producer, Carl Nesbitt is a prodigious talent, Irish Music Magazine. A multi-instrumentalist, Carl is also an album producer, soundtrack composer, traditional music tutor. And Carl has done 14 albums, six of which he produced, that gently cross genre from Irish traditional, folk, indie, film, and electronic. And Carl has a fantastic YouTube channel with amazing tutorials, and also his website address there for his lessons, his email address. So here's the latest from Carl Nesbitt. I pulled up this, and this is a fabulous bit of music from Carl and his friend Tommy Kniff. And I'll just play a little bit of a YouTube tutorial first from Carl to get you to speed with what Carl has been up to. And this is a fantastic clip of music from the Aula Maxima with Carl Nesbitt on bouzouki, Tommy Kniff on the button box, and Mel Mercier on the baron and traditional Irish percussion, the bones, and lots of other things as well. And here is two tunes from Carl Nesbitt, composed by Carl Nesbitt. They are called Think Tank and Give Her Holly, and Tommy Kniff is going to introduce them now.
First one's called Think Tank, and the second tune is called Give Her Holly. And they can also be found on Carol's new album, Vista Point. So keep an eye out for that one. Thank you.
Thanks everybody who have ordered from MáiréadNesbittViolin.com for all things musical, and also solstice.shop for the Celtic inspired jewellery collection by myself. And I really appreciate it at this time especially, and it's great that you all support your favourite artists. And MáiréadNesbittViolin.com has loads of music and accessories and lessons and lots of things. And today's star order from there is Dorothy Reedy from Tulsa, Oklahoma. Dorothy, you ordered the Swarovski adorned violin mute, and here's my one. I love it. And you ordered the one in the fire colors, so thank you so much for that. Thanks also to everyone who've become a supporter on Facebook. It's a new thing that I'm doing, and I really appreciate you all being there, seeing exclusive content that normally would not be on any of the other platforms. So I'm having great fun with that, and thanks to everyone who have joined this week. And also thanks to everybody who have got their cameo messages this week. It's a great gift for people, and I can't say the names because some of them are surprise gifts. So thank you so very much, everyone. As always, I love doing a tune from my mother, Kathleen Nesbitt's fiddle tutorial and included 41 track CD. And it's available on MáiréadNesbittViolin.com. And I picked a tune this week that's a slide. A slide is 12/8 and it is very energetic. The dancers in Ireland love dancing to the slides, especially the set dancers, which is a group of dancers dancing together. And I picked a tune called O'Callaghan's Slide, and I do a lot of bow triplets in this tune, and that is an ornament done with your bow hand. And O'Callaghan's Slide is on page 88 of the book. Hope you like it. Thank you. I do have a Celtic spell for you today, guys. I have a wonderful story about Inisfree. And with the beautiful Órla Fallon on today, I couldn't let that go. And I saw a few very special requests on Twitter and on all the social platforms for Inisfree from Órla as well. So we do have that for you too. And I just want to set up this Celtic spell for you. This is Inisfree, and of course we're all familiar with the Yeats poem, the great poet W.B. Yeats. I will arise and go now, and go to Inisfree, and to a small cabin built there of clay and wattles made. 9 bean rows will I have there, a hive for the honeybee, and live alone in the bee-loud glade. And I shall have some peace there, for peace comes dropping slow, dropping from the veils of the morning to where the cricket sings. There midnight's all a glimmer and moon a purple glow and evening full of linnet's wings. I will arise and go now, for always night and day I hear lake water lapping with low sounds by the shore. While I stand on the roadway or on the pavements grey, I hear it in the deep heart's core. We are all familiar with that wonderful poem, but did you know that there's a legend concerning that poem? At Inisfree, a daughter of a great chieftain of the district who asked her lover, a young warrior known as Free, to procure her some of the forbidden fruit and prove to her his love and affection. Free rode over to the island and a great battle took place between him and a monster that protected the island. Free slayed it and weak and exhausted from his fight and feeling the need for refreshment, tasted some of the stolen fruit. The fruit unknown to Free was fatal to mortals and soon after tasting some, he felt the poison take effect on his body. Free gathered the remainder of his strength and rowed across the shore where he fell at his lover's feet. Before he died, he told her of his fate and how it came to be and not to eat from the luscious looking fruit. She was immediately filled with remorse and ate the stolen fruit and the two lovers were buried on the island. So there you go, guys. And there you go, guys. That was a beautiful legend there and a Celtic spell for you from the Isle of Inisfree. And I do have the beautiful, you did request, the wonderful Órla Fallon from our very first DVD together. And this DVD, of course, is the Celtic Woman DVD. And it's Celtic Woman's 15th anniversary this year. And this was an absolute highlight from the DVD, and you all requested it. So here it is, Isle of Inisfree by the wonderful Órla Fallon.
I've met some folks who say that I'm a dreamer, and I've no doubt there's truth in what they say, but sure a body's bound to be a dreamer when all the things he loves are far away, and precious things are dreams unto an exile. They take him o'er the land, across the sea, especially when it happens he's an exile from a dear lovely Isle of Inisfree. And when the moonlight peeps across the rooftops of this great city, wondrous though it be, scarcely feel its wonder or its laughter. I'm once again back home.
Isn't that wonderful, everybody? Órla was a highlight, that's for sure. And I just want to tell you a little bit about what Órla has been up to. And she says, I have been privileged in the places music has brought me, says Órla. Given the places she's been in the past years, it would be difficult to disagree. US Presidents Clinton and Bush and Irish President Mary McAleese are all part of Órla's audience, both as a solo artist and a member of the phenomenally successful group Celtic Woman. Órla's first public television special, Órla Fallon's Celtic Christmas, put her back at the center of PBS television in the US. Órla featured in another public television special entitled My Land. And this was a geographical and cultural celebration featuring the legendary Dubliners, Tommy Fleming and Damien Dempsey. Órla, who credits her late grandmother with instilling an abiding love of Irish music and culture, was named the Billboard Best Album Charts, reaching number 4 on the world music charts for her album Órla Fallon's Celtic Christmas. Her next album, Lullaby Time, entered the Irma Indie charts at number 9 to huge acclaim. Órla then released her next album, Sweet By and By, and incorporating songs from the Americana tradition. Available on all platforms and her website, orlafallon.com, her awaited album, which is extremely exciting, Lore, comes out July 24th. And that is amazing. I can't wait for that. It's such great news. And of course, all her albums are amazing. This is the cover of Sweet By and By with the Americana traditional songs and a lovely photo from My Land as well there. And I have a wonderful, wonderful version of Mogila Mar from that show. And I hope you enjoy this. This is absolutely stunning. It has some of the best musicians in Ireland on it. Noel Eccles, John O'Brien, lots of great musicians, and of course Anuna. And treat yourself to this, everyone.
Mae'r sgwyl a gwy, mae'n bwcl byw, smyr i'n ddartw.
Is fantastic, and I can't wait to introduce my brilliant and beautiful pal, original member of Celtic Woman, solo artist Órla Fallon, and I'm adding her now. Hi, Órla.
Hi, Máiréad. How are you? So lovely to see you and to be here on your lovely, lovely show.
Oh, thank you so much, Órla, for coming in and being with us all. My goodness, what you've done so much since Celtic Woman as well. You have so many solo albums, and you must be so excited with your new solo album, Lore, and it's coming out July 24th.
Yeah, I'm really excited about it, and but I was really taken back when it's so long since I watched that version of Inisfree, and I thought of us in the Helix, and we're meeting for the first time, and you touching up my makeup side stage, and the great time we had. And you're always great at the makeup, and just the lovely time. And you know, that song is a song that means so much to so many people, and I'm thinking of my poor old dad who's passed away since then. And it was a very special, magical time, and all the times that we had on the road, and that song, and it just brought me right back. And so it's lovely. I feel just so blessed in the music that, you know, you get the chance to meet so many people, and that the songs and the music take you to so many places, and that they mean so much to so many people. So with this new CD, Lore, it's like all the old songs that I've grown up with, because with Sweet By and By, I kind of dipped my toe in the water with some of the Americana songs. But I went back to my roots, to the old trad songs that I've been singing since I was like three. And it's great to get the chance to record those. And I'm really excited. You know, we've given people little tasters of the songs, and they're, you know, people are so wonderful and so supportive, and they seem to be genuinely excited about it. So I'm excited about it too. Yeah.
Oh, absolutely. And what beautiful artwork, Órla. It's so beautiful. It looks gorgeous.
Yeah, I was delighted. Yeah. I'm so lucky. I work with a brilliant, brilliant people in Nashville. And they've got, because we're working together for jeepers over 10 years now. So they know me really well. And when Greg Howard sent me the cover, I was like, oh my God. He said, I knew you'd love it. So it's real. It's me. And I think it captures the essence of what the album is about and the songs. It's very, I like simple things. I don't like fuss. And I think they captured this. It's just a very simple magic about it. And it's lovely.
Absolutely, Órla. And, you know, very classy, as always, from a very classy lady like yourself. So beautiful. And I can't wait to hear the whole album. And, you know, getting back to the Celtic Woman days, I remember that night well, us touching up our makeup. Oh. And, you know, it's always hectic before a show like that, wasn't it? It was just, and we had such great fun on tour.
Oh, shoot, you know what? It was great. But, you know, Máiréad, I was terrified the night of that show in the Helix because I had never sung, like, it was always me and my harp. Yeah. And I'd never sung with, like, such a big orchestra. And then seeing yourself and you were tearing across the stage. Oh, my God, you were just amazing. Like, I'd never seen the likes of you before. So I was mesmerized. I was like, oh, my God, I have to go on after hers. Like, oh, I was terrified. So I was hiding behind the harp. But you know what? It was just a little bit of magic. You know, we never thought what would come, you know, when we were all there and we were all in our own little way kind of, well, I was mesmerized and terrified and excited at the same time. And jeepers, we never knew what would come out of it and the adventures that we would have been on. And boy, did we have lots of adventures. So it was great. Yeah,
we surely did. And we put the world to rights, like with all our conversations off the stage as well as on.
And Máiréad and me were great. We used to go out for lovely dinners and we used to be chatting and oh my God, we were putting the worlds to rights and we'd have these great conversations, very deep conversations, and they were fabulous. And yeah, never forget it. It was great.
It was almost like therapy, Órla, for me anyway, you know, just the night off, the one night off you get in the week and we'd have our dinner.
Do you know? Yeah, we worked hard. Like we really did. Like when you think of it now, I wouldn't be able for that kind of a schedule. Now maybe I'm getting older, but jeepers, it was crazy. Like you could do 7 or 8 shows in a row and then you'd have a day off and you'd be just wrecked. But we used to always love to find a nice steakhouse, you and me. We used to call it our mortgage dinner and go out for one nice dinner and throw the works at it. Yeah,
That was our treat for sure. And, you know, I mean, it's a big Celtic Woman family. And sure, you know what? It's congratulations to us all for the 15th anniversary this year. It is fantastic. Yeah. And you know, we've loads of comments, of course, coming in. Órla, you know, Shilji says, Órla, I can't wait for your new album. And Shilji's a singer herself.
Thank you, Shilji. She's great. Oh, and she's a great singer. Fantastic
singer. She is. And great seeing the two of you visit while we watch Lucy Baisley. Alan Demarest.
Lovely. Hi, Lucy.
Yeah. And the happiness to see you together again from Alan there. And let's see.
Oh, do you know what is brilliant? It's the wondrous... The wonders of technology brought us together again. So it's great.
I know. And Samantha for Sir, one of my favorites is Carrick Fergus. I know. One of my favorites is Carrick Fergus too.
Oh.
Very, very nice. And
love it. I love that song.
There's so many comments. And I'm just going down through them here because there's so many, Órla. Órla, you're awesome. DPG Worldwide, Digital Promotions Group.
Oh, thank you. Woo-hoo.
And... I love the celebration.
Thank you so much.
Aww. And, Órla inspired me to play the harp for 7 years now from Kayla Elizabeth Frank. That's beautiful.
Kayla is an amazing harpist. And, you know, she did a fantastic arrangement of I recorded the song Feet of a Dancer a few years ago. And she did a brilliant harp version of it. And I was so blown away by it. She's a brilliant, brilliant girl. And I was lucky to meet Shayla as well when I did a concert in Binghamton. And she's a great, great girl. A fab harpist.
Oh,
yeah.
It's lovely. And Dee, our friend Dee, the name of your album is the same as my surname. I'm definitely getting looking forward to it, and he's definitely getting it, so that's lovely.
Perfect. Well, I hope you'll enjoy it.
Everybody's going to enjoy it, Órla. And you know, you have so many beautiful songs done, and you know, visually as well as orally, you know, and your harp playing is so beautiful, Órla. And you know, we were looking at a beautiful song called Distant Shore, and you like that song, don't you? And you suggested that we might do it here.
Yeah, that's a really special song. It was written by, well, Dan Shea, who I'm working with since I left Celtic Woman. He's based in California, but I always say to him, he's a great man for the tunes. He knows every Irish tune. He's introduced me to Irish tunes. Mm-hmm. But he has worked over the years with the lyricist John Bettis, who's an amazing, you know, he wrote all those like Carpenter songs, I'm on the Top of the World. He wrote Whitney Houston's One Moment in Time. And we sent him the tune of Distant Shore, and he said, he smokes a pipe. He says, Dan, I'll have your lyrics. You know, he said, I see a shore miles away, and the connection between people and this distant shore. And all through lockdown and all through this coronavirus, I kept thinking, this is a song that's very relevant to now, because so many people feel cut off and isolated from their loved ones. But we know that we will meet again on a distant shore. And it's very special. It's a lovely, lovely song. And on the video, we've got some scenes, some footage. Like, I'm actually up on the cliffs of Moher, and I nearly get vertigo when I look at it, because you turn around and I'm right standing at the edge. It's a beautiful, very special song. And I was very blessed, because I've worked with John a few times, because he wrote the lyrics to Lullaby Time as well. A lovely, he's so talented, but so lovely and so unassuming. And so Distant Shore is and will always be a very special song.
Yeah, well, do you know what? I think we'll put it on now for everybody. This is the beautiful song Distant Shore with the fantastic Órla Fallon.
And torn, I still believe.
Oh my goodness. Orla, it's like, you know, you have the lighter like that or the phone. Oh, it's so beautiful.
It's a lovely song. Yeah, and it started off, Dan called it his Irish idea. It was like his Irish tune. And then I said, no, we have to put lyrics to it. It's so nice because we were going to have it as an instrumental. And it's lovely. And you know, I'd forgotten about all the different places because there's the cliffs of Moher and then there's the beach in Dingle and it never stopped raining.
It rains a lot in Dingle.
Yeah. Oh my gosh, it does. It does. Yeah.
Oh my God, I know that myself.
Yeah.
But
so
many beautiful comments. There's a big comment here. Orla's the first harpist I've listened to who has really brought the harp to light. Over the past few months, I've met and became friends of five other different harpists who are all special in their own way. Nothing can beat the haunting, magical sounds of the harp. David Abbott. Aww.
Thank you,
David. And so many other comments saying how beautiful that song is. It is and really it's very touching for now, Orla, you know especially people who are away from home.
People who are missing relatives and who are missing family, and like yourself, you can't come home. And even my mom was talking about it the other day. She says, do you sing Distant Shore these days? She said it's so relevant for the times we're in. And it really, really is. Yeah, it's a lovely song.
It certainly is. And Orla, I just, you know, I know you're very busy and I don't want to keep you too long, but I mean, there's so many lovely, I just wanted to show, I don't speak that language. I wish I did. That's amazing from somewhere. And fabulous people watching from all over the world, Orla and Karsten. We love Karsten.
Wow.
Karsten's boy, Orla's voice.
Oh, Karsten's fantastic. He's so great. He's such a wonderful support to all of us. Karsten is the best. There's no one like Karsten.
Absolutely. And he is so supportive of us all. And Samantha says, I stayed in Dingle for 3 days and I think we had sun for 10 minutes.
That'd be it. Even this time last year, we went down to Dingle and we were so excited, myself, my husband and our little boy. And you know what? The rain, I had hair out to here. It was just frizzella, but it was brilliant. And, you know, we're on the beach and Freddie actually always says, because we were kicking football on the beach and John kept saying, the ball is going to end up in the water. And the ball was carried out. And this was his favorite football. And I said, it's on its way to America. And he only said to me the other day, do you remember when my football went to America?
Oh my goodness.
But it's a lovely, but Dingle is a magic spot. My mother went to school in Dingle, you know, and actually there's a gorgeous song, Marie. I'm sure you know it, Dingle Bay.
Oh, it's beautiful.
Do you know that song, Dingle Bay? It's a great song. Yeah, I wanted to do it on the album, but we ran out of space. So please God, the next album, I'll put that on it because it's a gorgeous song. Yeah, it's my mother's favorite song. So I have to record it the next time.
You have to do that. You have to. Yes.
Yeah,
if it's her favorite song, then do it.
Yeah.
Yes, oh, Orla,
it's a great song. It's a great song.
You know, it is a beautiful song. And I just want to show everybody your cover of Lore. Lore is going to be out on July 24th. It's Orla Fallon's new album. And all of us cannot wait for that to come out. And of course, we have seen snippets of it on your socials. And, you know, everybody, you know, go on to Orla's socials and her website, which is orlafallon.com.
That's it. Yeah, thank you
very
so
good.
Much. Yeah, that's my website. Yeah.
Yes,
yeah.
Go on there and have a look there, everybody. But it's going to be a real treat when that comes out. And I can't wait, Orla. And, you know, it's so great to see you today. And we have a real treat because now you're going to go into the kitchen, the other part of the kitchen, and you're going to try and set up your harp there. And I'm going to keep people occupied here. But just before you go, I do want to say thank you so very much for taking the time to be with us today, and you're a great friend and I love you so much, Orla, and I really appreciate you being on.
Oh, listen, you've no idea how much it means to be here this evening, Marie. You're the best. There's no one like you, and I'm just so thrilled and honored to be here. And you never lost it, as they say. You're still the same, and it's just lovely. Yeah, it's like we're taking up where we left off, just like
exactly, you know, taking up
yeah, it's brilliant. And that's And that's the sign of a true friend, you know. Yes. So you just pick up where you left off, and that's brilliant. And there's no one like you. Yeah.
Oh, yes, it is, Órla. Well, look, I'm just going to give you a chance there to go to your harp. And thank you so much for being on today. And thank you so much for playing another tune for us. So we're going to look forward to that now in a minute or so. So we'll see you then, Órla. Great. And thank you so much.
Great. And thank you so much. Thank you. And thank you to everybody who tuned in and for all your lovely comments. You're great. And it's so nice to be here. So take care and see you again soon on a distant shore.
On a distant shore. Mwah. Oh, isn't that fabulous? And I'm going to give Órla a little bit of time to get ready with her harp. And she's going to go to a different part of the house. So I am going to thank people for their lessons, because it was great to see everybody this week.
Thanks everybody for coming back to your lessons this week. It was so great to see you all and catch up with you, and it's so easy to book them on the calendar at MáiréadNesbittViolin.com, and the more you book, with the better bundles and deals that you get. So it was great to see you, and I'd love to thank Frida Hagen in Norway, Lisa Bybee, New Hampshire, USA, Brianna Lulever in Ontario, Canada, Elizabeth Callahan, California, USA, Tiffany Moore, Chicago, USA, and Catherine Richter in South Carolina, USA. It was great to see you all, and I'll see you next week for your lesson.
So I'm here in my kitchen because I think there's a nice sound in here, and the song that I'm going to sing for you is one that I've been doing for many, many years, and I know you know it well, so I hope you'll enjoy this version of Alleluia na Gaeilge.
I love to finish off with a tune on the viola, and this is from my mother Kathleen Nesbitt's fiddle tutorial and CD, and it's a beautiful slow air. It's on page 58 of the book, and it's called Thirna Vuo, and I love this tune. It's so beautiful, and thank you so very much everybody for tuning in today and every week. It was great to catch up with you all, and especially with my special guest this week, Órla Fallon. And I'll see you next Monday with another amazing special guest. And don't forget to tune in to Máiréad Mondays Chats, Tunes and Crack podcast. The link is below. It's always great to put on when you're doing stuff around the house. And this is Tírna Vuo, and I'll see you next Monday.